Hi everyone. My name is Alex Foster and I'm the CEO of Race Yourself. We're a fitness entertainment company. What we allow people to do is to run against themselves, to race against themselves, to race against their friends, to race against their friends, and to race against celebrities, and to race against zombies. We're fitness entertainment. What that means is that on the face of it, we're making exercise fun and addictive. But really what we're doing is we're a painkiller. We're a painkiller for one of the world's largest problems: lack of exercise motivation. So we're Race Yourself, and this is our big vision.
Okay, life's a race. But since when is it about coming first? It's not about her, or him, or, yeah. This is about you. You're at the starting line. See, this is your race. Let's go. Improve yourself. Challenge yourself. Nice work. Enjoy yourself. Always wanted to try that. Push yourself. Test yourself. Is crazy. Race yourself. She gets it.
Cool. Well, that's our big vision. Now you might be thinking, okay, glass isn't that immersive, but it will be. We know about 15 competitive products at the moment. I think it's going to take a bit more than a couple glass holes to stop that market from kicking off eventually. I encourage you to check out the demo. Richard, over here, will be showing it off. It's pretty cool. It's not super beautiful yet, but technology works, and if you check it out, I think it's very impressive. You can race against yourself indoors, or you can save a woman from a train tied up on the tracks. We're on smartwatch and mobile as well. Our smartwatch product we started about 4 weeks ago. We got approached by Samsung, who asked us to make it for their Gear 2. Again, not a work of art yet, but again, check out the demo. It's I think you can see sort of how it's going to become something that's very addictive and very motivating. Effectively simulating a race through a visual experience. The one to really look out for is the Moto 360. It's coming out later this year, and we're super excited about it. It's because it looks like something we'd want to wear. It looks like a real watch. It's got a circular design, and I'm looking forward to styling Race Yourself to it. I think it's going to be a winner. But I can tell you one really big difference about this market compared to the previous ones. So if you look at the last three major new markets to come out, each one has grown considerably faster than the previous one. So we expect the new wearable displays to grow extremely quickly. Whether that's this year or next year, when someone gets hold of it and gets it right, we expect it extremely well. And just the same, this new market is different to previous in that it's not a standalone device. These are second screens. You use them in conjunction with mobile. And so any consumer-facing product on the smartwatch or on glass is going to need to be anchored in mobile, and we're no exception. So this is our mobile product. It's focused around competing. And the really big thing is, let's say I've gone for a run or a ride, I can send that to a list of my friends, and they then receive a notification on their phone saying, Alex has challenged you to beat his 5K time. That is an extremely motivating thing to receive, especially if it's going to expire. If I've got 3 days to show my friend up, I'm almost certainly going to get out on the road. So this is the design that we've been working on. You see it's sort of focused on receiving notifications, receiving challenges, and sending challenges. But also worth noting is the ranking system. Every player is given a rank based on their skill level, and rather than sort of a Strava sort of system where you're 2,400th in place and then you're 2,300th in place, you have an actual identity with something. You're silver 2. You progress and then you're silver 3 and silver 4, and eventually you're gold and then so on and so forth. Far stronger identity. Same thing. Of the rest, We have far higher GPS positioning accuracy than most competitors, which is really useful. Our revenue model is one for in-app purchases. We sell experiences. You start off, you can race yourself, you can race your friends. If you want to run against zombies, or if you want to race Usain Bolt, that's going to cost you $1. Similarly, if you want to do heart rate monitor training, that's something we offer, but the heart rate monitor is something that we sell. We have a couple of really cool partnerships. I can't broadcast most of them, but I can tell you we have a partnership with the fastest cyclist in the world, the most popular running game in the world, and the fastest growing race day event organizer in the world. I've kind of a minimalistic style to my slides. This one, I couldn't really do that for. We have a really awesome team, and I couldn't bear to delete any bullet points, so I won't go through them. But in short, they're incredible. This is a montage I put together of feedback we've received, just to make a point. I tell people about this idea, and almost nobody says, I wouldn't like that. This sounds to most people like a really motivating thing. And it shows through what people say. We've had some really awesome press. Fast Company told me we were crazy, which was good. And in summary, we offer three main things. Distraction from pain, from what you're doing during the run, give you something else to think about. Mission, we give you a goal. It's not just you run 400 meters, it's you're 400 meters ahead of your friend, or 50 meters ahead of some zombies, run faster. And couch power. So you're not just going for a run, turning on your app beforehand, tracking it during, and then seeing it afterwards. You're getting calls to actions when you're not exercising. Reasons to get back out on the road. And that's something we really focus on. So yeah, that's us. Any questions?
So you kind of teased this, but it seems like you're aware that Google Glass is not actually appropriate for the scenario that you laid out in your video. I've run with Google Glass. You're kind of like doing this, and it's not fun, and it's not a good experience. So realistically, when are we going to have hardware that people can go out and buy? I mean, today was the one day that you could even go out and buy Google Glass, and it's not the right product. When are we going to have hardware that actually enables the experience that you're promising?
I guess two answers. First one, check it out on Glass. Check out our product now, because it's pretty cool, and I love it. I go for runs in it.
You're looking out to the side constantly.
Yeah, so it's a reference activity.
You need to be watching where your feet are going.
And there's two different ways of doing it. I mean, the way I run is that I'll go for a run, and I'll look up for two reasons. One, because I get a notification saying somebody's catching up behind you, or because I'm catching up behind something else, or because I just want to know how well I'm doing. I think a fully immersive activity actually is something that everyone's probably not quite ready yet for, because you could run in front of a bus. So we be careful about that. In terms of when the other products are coming to market, there's a whole bunch coming this year and quite a few coming next year. So bring it on.
I would say focus on the smartwatch market. Just my advice.
Sure.
Question in the back.
So given the limitations around Glass, and that people have been doing this in the fitness space for a while in certain divisions, like say for example, some of the treadmills or some of the cycling kind of gear that's gone out, and you can find the gyms these days that have been kind of received with phenomenal, mixed sort of reviews in a way. Do you feel though that there's an opportunity from what you guys are doing here that you could have an impact there? And then the second question I want to speak in is, do you see yourselves focusing on building your own applications, or do you see yourselves potentially opening this up for other developers to use your platform and as sort of a toolkit to develop applications like this for a whole wide range of devices?
Sure. So question one, firstly I challenge the premise. There have been some fitness softwares that have come out that have been very heavily criticized. Most of them are rubbish. And there have been some that have been extremely successful. The top 10 run trackers at the moment are little more than glorified stopwatches, yet between them they have more than 200 million users. It's pretty impressive for a stopwatch. Second question, what was it again?
Do you see yourself opening up the platform for other developers?
We do. We've had a couple people ask already. I think it's really interesting. I think until the underlying platform takes off, that's not a major revenue stream. You need to have a lot of developers using your underlying code before you start making good money off of it.
Sometimes.
Or some really big guys, yeah.
One more question. Anybody else? All right, one more round of applause for Alex.